We must still unthrone her, my point. The great love story aside.
She may sit on your face, but not on your throne.
It was a joke.
You will see a lot of different characters who you didn't see interact together on season one.
We've got a great ensemble of actors who bring so much to the table.
Huzzah!
Huzzah! You get to see the characters that you enjoyed in the first season developing in really fun ways.
This is great.
We're his new best friend.
Exactly. I can be everything Gregor was to him. Yeah.
What is it, bitch?
Mariel's Catherine's cynical voice of reason. I'm quite honest with her.
You betrayed me.
Saved.
Betrayed.
Are you alive?
Catherine still kind of holds that over her a bit.
Would you like some, Mariel?
So you do remember my name?
Of course.
Mariel and Gregor have this fantastic relationship in season two. That's very exciting.
What are you doing? Changing the world. Mariel and Catherine are both hungry for power, and we are using each other. She is stubborn, yes, but she is also brilliant.
I hold out my hand in friendship. I do not want to close it into a fist.
Archie gets visions from God by taking magic mushrooms in the woods.
Did you see him?
I saw shining light. They didn't have such a great start.
He's the traditionalist. He wants to keep things exactly the way they are. So that puts him in opposition to Catherine.
You are a German devil who has stolen our country and is intent on burning Russia to the ground.
Archie, be on the right side.
Georgina really admires Catherine.
I've always felt a strong connection with you.
We have had sex, which I do not enjoy much.
She is in this really unusual relationship with both Peter and her husband, Gregor.
You summon me?
It's an interesting little love triangle, I suppose. Gregor is Peter's best friend and confidant.
You need to shut up.
I'm worried his love for Catherine is a break on our plans.
I do not love her.
Huzzah!
Riggle's probably one of the few people in the court who Peter can really be himself and show his weakness.
Seems a bit strong. She came to me unbidden.
You must make her believe there is more to you than there is.
Elizabeth is really interesting because on one hand, she's a bit of a political player, but she's also a bit of a bohemian.
And pin a crown on a donkey, it is still a donkey.
She realizes that Catherine, I think, has amazing attributes that would make her a brilliant leader.
The joy of being a woman is knowing that we have unseen and unacknowledged depths and strengths beyond anything a man will ever know.
All right, of course. Sorry.
Developmental is still fairly old-fashioned in my thoughts about whether a woman and a young woman can actually lead.
I shall ready battle plans.
What is wrong with you?
A general readies war plans. It's sort of the job.
There's a sort of journey to go on with her where I gradually believe in her.
It's a war, Orla. I take it personally.
She dies, he comes back.
Catherine and Orla, together, they'll bring the best out of one another, making Russia great again.
In one moment, 58 million people are freed.
Steps. A mile is made in steps.
I teach Catherine how to play the game here at the palace.
Head, not heart, Catherine.
Reason, not rage, Orlo.
And Catherine teaches Orlo to live dangerously, be fearless, and take some big risks.
I had sex last night with a woman.
Cute.
I like that you're fitting all these different characters together that might not quite fit. I think from that comes really exciting ideas.
Huzzah.